microstrip power divider characteristics, power division and isolation characteristic. Here we have microwave signal source, FMA to FMA connector for join these two cables, 60 dB attenuator, 50 ohms match termination, power divider, RF detector, and I have three type of measuring devices. One is CRO measuring device, or VSWR, or power meter, RF power meter directly. I will explain with all these three, because in some colleges they have only CRO, in some colleges they have VSWR meter with CRO, in some colleges they have all three. These are the components used here: FMA FMA connector, female to female, 6 dB attenuator, fifty ohms terminate match termination, 50 ohms. Here it is, 50 ohms match termination. This is your power divider. Power divider, three port. This is port 1. I will call it as a P1. And this is P2 and P3. P2, P3. Port 2, port 3. This is division. Whatever the applied input to port 1, it is equally divided in port 2 and port 3. The same thing, if you apply same any power, suppose half milliwatt, if you give input to these ports, it will be added here. So this power divider can be used as a combiner also. So this is port 1, port 2, port 3. And next, this is a detector, passive detector. It is specified input. This is this side input port, RF input, and this is low frequency audio output. Okay, that message signal that will recover. This is a detector. If you use it as a reverse, this has a input wrong. And next, SMA to BNC. One side SMA connector is there, another side BNC. This is SMA, this is BNC. And next, we are using microwave signal source, and it is S band and CRO and VSWR meter and power meter. All three I have. I will show one by one. Turn on VCO. That is confirm. That is S band. Yes, it is S band. Frequency will start from 1.92. I am varying the frequency up to 3.362 gigahertz. So I will keep it to 2.5 gigahertz. It's okay, 2.485, no problem. Frequency is set to 2.5 gigahertz. It is 2.480, no problem. And next, we have to insert one 6 dB attenuator. It is a 6 dB attenuator. I have to connect this. This is RF output socket. This is RF output. So I have to connect there one 6 dB attenuator. And for CRO and VSWR meter, means I have to select modulation down and select 1 kilohertz frequency. So if you keep anti-clockwise fully, the sound will come. Switch is offed, means default 1 kilohertz is selected. That is required for VSWR meter measurements. And keep RF level maximum, and I will tell you how much level we can apply, because the detector, it will work under square law. So if we cross that square law region, we are in linear mode. Then the readings are wrong. So I will tell you how much level we can apply, RF power, RF strength. Okay. Then these two are the cables, SMA cables, RG188 cables, 50 ohms. So this is male connectors. So it is useful to connect the power divider. Now this is RF level. I have to set this. Now it is in maximum. So after using one attenuator, RF circuit, this is RF output from VCO, connect 60 dB attenuator, RF. After that you connect one cable. This is FMA-FMA connector, joined, see, this is FMA-FMA connector to connect these two cables. So your power divider will come here, DUT, device under test. So now it is short, so RF power is coming to your detector. Also you observe which is in, which is out. So RF in, this is in and this is out. Out is low frequency, message signal only we are receiving. So that output is connected to CRO, see. Okay. So that output is, here it is point, I am using second channel, 0.5 into approximately 1.5 box, 0.75 volts. We don't want that much. I will reduce this by this knob, RF level knob. This knob, I will vary. What happens, see. If I vary that, that amplitude will reduce. So I will set it to 40 millivolts. That is enough. Here it is, in CRO scale is 20 millivolts. So two box, I have to set this. Set this to 2 box. See, 2 box into 20 millivolts. It is a 40 millivolts is enough for our experiment. After this, we have to connect here power divider. Before that, note down the RF input. So now I am connected directly. So that is my input to power divider, port 1. So I am already told this is port 1. I will apply 40 millivolt here, 40 millivolt RF signal. So I have to get 20 millivolt, 20 millivolt. Equally it should be divided, half power, because we are seeing on CRO is power only, that is not voltage. So two boxes is there. So it becomes 20 millivolt means one box. I will show you. I will make it very close to your camera. See, this is two box. Okay. Now I will connect power divider. Now I am removed this female to female connector. Before I am connected this and this cable using this female to female connector. Now I am removed and now I connected. This is input, RF input to port 1 or P1, and next this is one port, this is one port divided. So when I am taking output from one port, another port should be terminated with 50 ohms termination. It is already terminated. This is output. So what happened on CRO? See, it is one box. Previously it is two box, now it is one box. It is half. So input is 20 millivolt, output is input is 40 millivolt, 20 into two box, input is 40 millivolt and output is 20 millivolts. So that means it is 3 dB minus 3 dB. It is 3 dB power divider only. So next I will do, I will change this. I have to measure another port 3. So port 2 should be terminated and port 3 connected to output. Okay, just interchange. So just observe, it is one box only. Okay, 20 millivolts. My RF input is 40 millivolt, input is 40 millivolt, output is 20 millivolt divided equally. So you calculate with using 10 log, you will get in dBs. So remove this. So now I am connected, FMA connected directly. So remaining all setup same. So now I am using, instead of CRO, I am using VSWR meter. Same detector I am using, in and out, same thing. Only the probe from CRO to VSWR meter I am changed. So same thing, no need to change any RF level. Previously we set it to 40 millivolts, that is enough. You just check the VSWR meter, how much we are getting. So after connecting to VSWR meter, it is in zero. Needle should be within the scale, it is out of scale, more than 10. So select this range dB. So here it is coming. So for now it is in 40 dB range, and make it to, using these two fine and coarse, bring it to zero. This should be normal. This should be normal. This is at 200K, not at crystal. Keep it at 200K. This is input. This is normal. Minus 40 dB. And select this to bring it to zero on scale. Okay. I will bring it to zero. Here, from the bottom, second red scale from 0 to 10 dB is there. You select that one because we are in normal here. Expanded means lost expanded scale. We are not using expanded. 0 to 10 dB scale from the bottom, second red scale. So here it is 40. I will bring it to 0. So here it is 40. This is 0, 40 dB. So my input is 40 dB. So here I am connected FMA connector. So now I have to replace this FMA connector with power divider. So my input is minus 40 dB. So what happens? This is minus 43. This is also minus 43. Minus 40 is the input. After power division, I have to get minus 43, minus 43. Okay, I will show you. So now power divider is connected. See, input, this is port 1 RF input, port 2 is output, port 3 is terminated. So just observe the reading, it is previously minus 40. Now here 41, 42, 43, exactly we are getting 43. Okay, so I have to check for another port also. I have to replace this. So just interchange these two. This. So just interchanged 50 ohms termination and output cable, and again it is minus 3 dB only. So previously my input is minus 40 and the output is minus 43, minus 43. Equally it is divided. It is a 3 dB power divider. And we have to check one more thing. Isolation. Isolation means we have to give here these two output ports are there now. One is input and one is output. And input port P1 should be terminated here like this. This port should be terminated. See, like this. One is input, one is output, and input P1 port is terminated. Observe, it is already scale out of scale. So out of scale, what I will do, I will go next range here, range dB, 10 dB increased. So now I will read this. Here it is 50, 10 dB increased, 50, 51, 52, 53, 54, 55, 56, 57, 58 dB. So 40, 58. So 58 minus 40 means 18 dB. Minus 18 dB is isolation. I think we are not doing with CRO this. Very low in microvolts, 1 millivolt, like that we will get. It's very difficult. It can be using VSWR meter, it is very easy. We are getting directly in dB. So power division and isolation characteristics are over. So now next we will do it the same thing with power meter. I will show that. For the power meter, we don't want to use any this detector, and we have to change here one small change, this modulation to CW for power meter option. I will change that. So next we will do it with power meter. So this is power meter setup, microwave signal source, cables, and FMA connector, and power meter. The only one change, that modulation to CW, we changed already. So in this place I will bring power divider, input and output. One port should be terminated. I will show you. Before that, we have to we can use power meter like minus 5, it is showing. I will make it to 0 by pressing 0 setting, 0 dB, 1 milliwatt. Okay, so that means my input power is 0 here. When I bring this, my input is 0 dB, minus 3 dB, minus 3 dB reading I will get it. So I will remove this. See, it is zero dB or 1 milliwatt. Zero dB means 1 milliwatt. My reference is 1 milliwatt is 0 dB. So we are this. I am connected input RF 0 dB and output is minus 3 dB, minus 3.27. Now I will interchange these two. Okay, ports are interchanged. So now minus 3.27 dB m. So minus 3 dB, minus 3 dB, both are equally dividing. So next we have to check isolation. So one is input, one is output, and this port should be P1 terminated. Okay, so now one port is input here and this is output. So P1 is terminated. So minus 18.16 dBm, this is isolation. We are getting 18 dB isolation. Power division we should get minus 3, minus 3 as per design, and isolation we should get minus 20 dB. We are getting minus 18. Next we are doing couplers, parallel line coupler. This is a 4 port. This is port 1, port 2, port 3, port 4. So now I am using power meter. I am not using VSWR meter or CRO. In power divider experiment we explained, you want to do it, just follow the same procedure. But this switch towards modulation for CRO or VSWR meter. For power meter, keep it in CW, top. So that's the one change. So now I am connecting directly FMA to FMA connector, and I will make this to 0 dB, 1 milliwatt. Okay. I disconnected and I have to connect. This is my input port. This is insertion loss, isolation and coupling. This is 15 dB coupler. We are getting coupling value minus 15 dB, isolation greater than minus 30 dB, insertion hardly we are getting 1 dB, minus 1 dB. Theoretically we are not getting. That is almost all. Just follow the input. Whatever the input is applied, that we should get. So terminate these two ports we are not using, and this is you connect to power meter. See how much we are getting in power meter. Minus 0.68. It is less than 1 dB we should get, we are getting it. Minus 0.59. And isolation. For isolation, you just interchange. Any port should not open. It is connected with 50 ohms. Say it is greater than minus 30. I told already we are getting minus 31.87 dBm. dBm means our 1 milliwatt is 0 dB, our reference. So that's what we are calling m, dBm. 1 milliwatt is 0 dB. That is dBm. So we are getting isolation, we should get minus 30 and greater. We are getting, that is okay. And coupling port, it's a 15 dB coupler, we should get minus 15 dB. It is connected. See, input, these two we are not using, so terminated. This is we are connected to measurement. So that is, we just verify, it is minus 14.64. We should get minus 15. It's very closer. It's working beautifully. So this is your coupler. You want to check the characteristics and you want to vary the frequency and note down the readings. Also for any power divider, couplers, you can vary the frequency from this now and note down the readings and plot the graph also. Okay. This is a branch line coupler. Previously, this one parallel line coupler, already over. This is branch line coupler. This is also four ports, port 1, port 2, port 3, port 4. Here, this is the input port, this is the insertion loss, this is coupling, this is isolation. In this one, old one, this isolation, here it is coupling. This is coupling, here it is isolation. Interchange. Isolation and coupling ports are interchanged. So this is a 3 dB coupler. Previously we used this one 15 dB coupler. This one 3 dB coupler. So this is insertion loss also we are getting almost all 3 dB. See? It is 4 dB insertion loss is there. And next 3 dB coupler means coupling value also we are getting 3 dB only. So see, we are getting 3 dB only, 3.47 coupling value. So next one is the isolation. We should get greater than 10 dB, more than 10 dB isolation. Isolation is always high only. So So how much we are getting? Minus 13. So this is isolation port. I am connected. Minus 13.55. Minus 13.55. So one more reading is there. That one is watts, milliwatt, microwatt. If you want to note down, note down. No problem. Input, insertion loss. This is coupling. This is isolation. Four ports. Okay. In coupler experiments, we are using 250 ohms terminators. In power divider, only one is enough. And next is ring resonator. This is a ring resonator. Here we have to vary the frequency and find the resonating frequency. Okay. So this is input, RF input. This is RF output, and it is connected to power meter directly. Using one 6 dB attenuator in all the experiments, and it is in CW mode when power meter is used. So now I have to vary the frequency. Frequency knob is, I will keep like this. Okay, no problem. So here is the frequency knob. I have to vary this, then only frequency will vary. It is already, it will start from 1.9 gigahertz. So we have to vary and note down the power. So what happens now, it is minus 33.68 dB. At the resonating frequency, it will give you maximum power output, and again it will reduce. So observe, minus 33 is there. I will increase the frequency, and my ring resonator is designed for 2.5 gigahertz. So at the 2.5 gigahertz, I will get the maximum power output at that frequency. So I have to vary. See, 1.9 is there. We will make it 2 and note down the power output. Minus 33, 34 is there. Don't want to vary this power level. Vary the frequency only. 2.2 becomes minus 30. Power is going towards positive means power is increasing. You can observe in milliwatts. It is in nanowatt, 839 nanowatts. It will increase. Nano to, it is jumped to micro. See, 2.3 is 29. Going towards positive. Just increase the frequency. 2.4 gigahertz. Minus 22. So it's going towards positive. So my power is increasing. Resonator output power is increasing. So minus 17, minus 16, minus 15, minus 12, minus 11. Continuously I am varying the frequency. My power is increasing. Ring resonator output power. Minus 9, minus 8, minus 6, minus 5. So again it is decreasing, see, minus 12. So come back, where I get maximum power, just come back. Minus 6 is the highest, minus 5 also coming. So minus 5.75 is maximum power I am getting from the resonator output. So that frequency is 2.522. See this one. 2.522 gigahertz. My ring resonator is designed for 2.5 gigahertz. I am getting at 2.522 gigahertz. So I am getting this. So further, if I increase the frequency, what happens? See, it is power is reducing. It is going towards minus completely. 2.6, 2.7 gigahertz, 2.8 gigahertz, 2.886 gigahertz. So it is decreasing. So power is increased and decreased like this, increase, decrease. So resonance frequency is 2.522 gigahertz. After finding the resonating frequency, we have to replace with some other material. So this is your ring resonator. I'm already prepared one material. So see, I can cover this. So for that purpose, I have to remove this screws, four screws, and insert this material. So for that purpose, you find the resonating frequency first, where I get maximum power. I think this is the maximum power we are getting, 5.75 at 2.522 gigahertz. So this is resonating frequency. After inserting this material, it will shift to some other frequency. So this is called F1. And after inserting this, we are finding one more frequency, that is F2. You find these F1 and F2, then calculations. Okay. So now I am removed this glass. One glass is there. I removed this glass by opening four number screws. This is the screws I opened. After that, you insert this like this. It will not hold. I will keep like this. Insert this material. So this power has changed. So without that, you observe. So I removed. It is minus 5.68. After inserting this on that circle, how to insert? Exactly fixed to this circle. You have to cut this material like this. You have to fill the circle. It is exactly fixed. See, it is visible. So now minus 14 point power is changed. Not power changed, actually resonating frequency is shifted. So now I will vary this frequency to get the resonating frequency. So power increasing, power decreasing, minus 19, it is power decreasing. I am coming back. See, power is going minus 5, again minus 5 dB, where I slowly move. Seven, six, five. This is the maximum power at 2.485. Previously it is 2.522 gigahertz. That is F1, 2.522 gigahertz. Now it is 2.485 gigahertz. So this is F2. So after finding this F1 and F2, only calculations remaining, that I will show you. For ring resonator calculations, for W by H less than 1, then I have to use this formula. Otherwise, effective epsilon, second one. Okay, here calculator W by H, 2.41, it is greater than 1. So details given. So we are using second formula. It is given here. After substituting all, we are getting effective epsilon 2.55. Then we calculated effective epsilon for unknown material 2. This is we used unknown material. Okay. For that, this is the calculations. Epsilon 2 is equal to 2.59. Okay, unknown material. This is power divider. I already explained. This is P1, means port 1. Input applied 0 dB, for example, or 1 milliwatt. We are getting minus 3, minus 3 dB, or half milliwatt, half milliwatt. So we used with chip resistor. This one. See, there is a chip resistor. Okay, with the chip resistor, it is like this. So, and for isolation characteristics, see, This is for isolation characteristic. This is input, one side input and another side output, and this is input P1 is terminated. Okay, for this is for power division isolation characteristic, both are shown. And one more thing we have to explain, that tabular column and all. So what's the input taken, output, what all are the measurements we have to take. This is sample tabular column for power divider. Here only 3 ports, P1, P2, P3 selected. Suppose if for couplers, you have to use one more port, fourth port also. You, if you want to vary the frequency also, vary the frequency. Or one reading is enough, take one reading, see here it is for one reading. Port P1 input, P2, P3, we are getting 3 dB, 3 dB. When P1 is 0 dB. And isolation P2, P3 only. You have to calculate like this. Power division. This is your tabular column. Same, follow the same procedure for remaining experiment also. Ring resonator also. Vary the frequency and note down the output reading and plot the 2D graph X and Y. And this is for couplers. This is parallel line coupler, branch line coupler, input port, insertion loss, it is less than 1 dB, isolation greater than 30 dB, coupling 15 dB, all are minus. And this is branch line input, insertion 3 dB only, and this is coupling, that is also 3 dB, and this is isolation greater than 10 dB. This is coupler. You make a tabular column as per the number of ports. Please contact us for demo, quotations, service, projects, internship for students.